calling my phone. And I told you before that it's over, leave me alone. No, it's hurting you to see me gone. Dark clouds, you gon' see me storm. I won't go back, but trust me, you gon' hold that. Hold that. Play these games no more. I don't wanna be touching your name no more. I ain't tryna feel this pain no more. And I'm sorry, but my feelings ain't the same no more. Used to be my homie, you ain't gang no more. I am not a nigga you could claim no more. Traumatized, hoping it don't rain no more. You done put me through some things that done changed my aura. Now all around the world, I
Hey y'all, it's your boy One Trick Rock. Like and subscribe, give me a comment. Alright, so I wanted to do a little something that's probably going to be a little interesting to y'all today. I just want to give a little rundown of the draft picks and the draft years that Howie Roseman basically botched on. And that's it's far too many. I feel like any other GM would have been fired by now, would have been probably not in the league by how many picks he missed on in his kind of in his draft career. So I'm going to only go back 4 years. I'm not going to do the 2020 draft because, I mean, a lot of them is still, to be determined. But I'm going to go from 2019 to all the way back to 2016 when we drafted Carson Wentz. It just show you how bad this dude was at his job. Well, this dude is at his job because he's still currently the Philadelphia Eagles general manager. So, without further ado, here we go. All right, I'm going to start 2016. And the crazy thing about this draft is, this is only about, 4 years later? 4 or 5 years later? And we currently, from the 2016 draft, we have nobody on this roster from the 2016 draft. All right, so y'all know it was Carson Wentz, Isaac Seumalo, Wendell Smallwood, Big V, Blake Countess, Jalen Mills, and Alex McAllister. We currently have none of them on this roster right now. I mean, I praise Jalen Mills and Isaac Seumalo, Carson Wentz for helping us get our Super Bowl, but that's horrible. I mean, how many teams don't have nobody on their roster from the 2016 draft? It's not like it was 10 years ago. Like, nobody got, the only one that got a second contract was Carson Wentz. I mean, Jalen Mills too, but it was like a 1 year deal. I mean, but yeah, that's horrible. I get that draft. I mean, I'm going to get that draft a nice grade because Carson Wentz and them helped us get that Super Bowl in 2017. But overall, that draft class to me was an F because none of those guys are on this roster right now. All right, let's go to 2017. I get it. This was horrible too. There's only one guy from this draft that's on this roster, and that's Derek Barnett. So I'm gonna go Derek Barnett, Sidney Jones, Rasul Douglas, Matt Collins, Donnell Pumphreys, Shelton Gibson, and Nathan Gary. Currently on this roster, there's only one guy on there, and that's Derek Barnett. Horrible. I get that draft for F too. Well, Derek Barnett was a big helper in the Super Bowl run, so I got to give it a D minus. And that the way I'm drafting it right now is not, the way I'm putting it right now is not draft grades. It's just, did these guys help our roster in the past couple years? And obviously they couldn't help our roster because they're not on the team. So that's horrible, man. You heard how many draft picks I just rattled off? And only one of them is on your team still? Derek Barnett, Sidney Jones, Rasul Douglas, Matt Collins, Donnell Pumphreys, Shelton Gibson, and Nathan Gary. Currently, only one, all those guys are off the roster except Derek Barnett. I get that draft a D because we still have Derek Barnett. So I can't give it an F because it's still actually a guy that's contributed to the team on the roster. All right, so I'm in 2019. And I kind of like this draft, but we only had what, four draft picks. So is Andre Dillard, Miles Sanders, Sharif Miller, Clayton Thorson. Currently is only two of those guys on the roster. Sharif Miller and Clayton Thorson is gone. Clayton Thorson actually was gone that same season, like mid-season he got traded. What is this guy Howie Roseman doing? I get that draft. I'm going to have to get that draft right there a C-. Like, I like Miles Sanders, man. Miles Sanders is my guy. But he's really the only one that contributed on this roster, being as though Andre Dillard was only there. I think he only played like four or five games in the Eagles uniform in his two-year stint here. So this draft class right here is kind of to be determined. I mean, it's still to be determined, but still, that's horrible. You botched two out of the four draft picks. All right. Now, 2018. Oh, I'm sorry. Damn. 2018 is when Dallas Goedert, Avante Maddox, Josh Sweat, and Matt Pryor, and Jordan Mailata came in. All right, so this draft class right here, I think 2018 was our best draft class in that four-year stint. Dallas Goedert still contributed. Avante Maddox is still contributing. Josh Sweat is a great backup at DN. Jordan Mailata could be our starting left tackle this year. Matt Pryor, he's a swing man. He could play any position on the line except center. So 2018 is our best draft class, man. So out of those three years, not 2018, we botched them, basically. We botched them. All right, out of those 23 players, there's only nine still on the roster. That shows you how bad Howie Roseman is, man. That shows you how bad this dude is, man. Like, God, how you botch on that many picks? You picked 23 players in 4 years, and there's only nine still on the roster. And I only see about, like, four or five that's actually contributing to the team. Five, actually. Six. I see six guys that's contributed to the team out of nine, out of 23 players that you drafted. Any other GM would have got kicked to the curve. And that's why I say it's all about money to Jeffrey Lurie. It's all about money to him. Long as Howie Roseman is making those, is redoing those contracts to where Jeffrey Lurie is getting the bread, getting his money, he don't care. He don't care about it. Because any other GM, I don't care who it is, if they botched this many picks in this many drafts, they would have been kicked to the curve. Kick to the curve, man. And that's why I kind of like, I mean, that's why I'm kind of like up in the air about this draft coming up right now. Because why should we have trust in Howie Roseman? Why should we? We should not. Anybody that's saying they trust this dude is a goddamn liar. Because, dude, like, it was so many guys we could have got instead of these guys. You get me? Like, I understand drafting Sidney Jones in the second round because he was projected to be a first-round draft pick before he got injured. But it didn't work out. And I don't know if it was just us, our defense, our scheme, our not getting our players ready, but it didn't work out. Rasul Douglas. I felt like Rasul Douglas was better suited as a safety. He was big, physical. He wasn't afraid to tackle. He'd come up hit. Only thing is, he was a press corner, but he really couldn't guard speed. So, and you couldn't play him off because they just pick him off all the time because he couldn't really cover the short routes either, so he was better suited than me as a safety. But he went over to Carolina and had his best season of his career. I blame that on coaching. Mac Hollins was trash. I don't know why we picked that dude in the fourth round. But, I mean, he was a special teams guy. Donnell Pumphrey's flamed out. He never really did anything for us. Shelton Gibson, he was supposed to be a speed guy, but he couldn't run routes. He wasn't physical, and he couldn't run routes, so he couldn't really get open. Nathan Gary was one of the worst linebackers I ever seen, man. Dude could not read a run play to save his life. He couldn't read a blocking scheme for the offense. He could not read it. He followed. It's just bad. He just played bad football for us, man. Carson Wentz, I loved him, man. Like, I mean, I'm kind of sick that he's not here no more, but it is what it is. I mean, but Carson Wentz was our best draft pick in all 4 years. Wendell Smallwood was a bust. I like Isaac Seumalo. I like Big V. Big V was a good swing man. He was a backup though. He was good at what he did as a backup. Blake Countess, he left and came back about 3 times. Jalen Mills, I like Jalen Mills. I like Jalen Mills, man. I know you got burnt a lot of times, owing the double moves and all that, but he was real physical. He wasn't scared to show his emotions on the field. When he made a big play, he got up and told you that he just made a big play on you. So I like Jalen Mills. I like this attitude. Alex McAllister never got on the field for us. Man, Sharif Miller never got on the field for us. Clayton Thurston was a quarterback that got traded mid-season of his rookie year. Like, how often does that happen? That's horrible. I love Dallas Goedert. I love Avante Maddox. Well, I don't love Avante Maddox. I'm not going to lie. Avante Maddox is a bona fide slot receiver to me. I mean, slot corner to me. Nickel corner. He cannot play outside. He can't play press. He can't play off. He just get burnt. And once he get burnt, he get hurt. It's just like, I just like him in the slot. I like him in the nickel. I mean, more than anything. Jerry Mailata, I love him, man. He didn't play an ounce of football, like American football. Dude turned himself into a legit left tackle. Like, he could start left tackle for us this year. And that's why I say, what are we going to do with Andre Dillard? Because I'm pretty sure Jerry Mailata is going to take that spot. Andre Dillard is only in his third season of his career. He's still young. So what are we going to do with him? Can he play guard? He's just going to be a big V, basically. He's just going to be a big V, basically, and he back up anybody that get hurt. Like, it's crazy. I like Matt Pryor, but Matt Pryor, he get beat a lot, man. So it's, I mean, overall, I got to give Howie Roseman an F on the last 4 years. Like, overall, out of all 4 years, I got to give him an F. And like I said, any other general manager, he would have been gone by now. He would have been gone. But, I mean, apparently, Howie Roseman and Jeffrey Lurie are best friends. They brother. He's the son he never had, I guess. I don't know what it is. But, I mean, it is what it is. Like, all right, I'm going to get into a little bit of draft stuff before I get out of here, man. To me, I feel like our first two picks, I've been saying this for the longest, our first two picks should be defense. But I see all the bad things they're trying to say about Devontae Smith right now, and this is kind of pissing me off because do y'all see dude college numbers, bro? Like, dude, even when Jerry Jeudy was still there, Henry Ruggs was still there, all those guys, all Devontae Smith ever did was produce. And that's what you need. See, that's what's wrong with the Eagles. They go off analytics like speed and stuff like that, but they don't go off production. When the last time we got a real productive player out of college? Like a super productive player like Devontae Smith is a wide receiver. He just won the Heisman last year. Wide receivers don't win that receiver. I mean, don't win that award. Wide receivers do not win that award. It's either quarterback or running back. Dude won the Heisman. The Heisman Trophy. Like, we need to start going after productive players instead of just going after analytical players. Like a Jalen Reagor. Like a Hightower. Those all analytical players. They can run. They'll kill it in the combine. But when you actually put them pads on, is they going to produce for you. I know for a fact Devontae Smith will, because he was sitting behind two dogs and he still put up a 1,000-yard season, over 10 touchdowns. And then the following year, he come back and win the Heisman. Over 20 touchdowns. Damn near 2,000 receiving yards. He ran back punts. Like, come on, bro. Y'all can't tell me this boy gonna be trash in the league because of his size. Like, he's 6'6", probably 170, 160-something pounds. But dude is a football player. That's what we need. We need football players on this team. I'm tired of bringing in all these scrubs like Mac Hollins and stuff like that. Bro, like, come on. We need actual football players. And Nick Sirianni looked like he's a football coach. Like, he loves coaching up football players. Not track guys. Guys that are killing in the Olympics. He coaches football players, bro. And I know y'all sitting there, y'all, everybody doubting Nick Sirianni right now because of his interviews and stuff. But who cares about how this dude talks? Long as he can coach this team. That's all we need from him. Coach this team. Get us some wins. Get us in the playoffs. Get us some playoff wins. Get us the Super Bowl. That's all we need. Y'all sit here crying about how dude speaks. About him playing rock, paper, scissors with prospects. Like, come on, yo. Like, come on, Eagles fans. Y'all just so, I don't know. A lot of y'all is just airheads. Y'all get on my nerves. A lot of y'all know zip about football. Zero. Dust. Oh, y'all wouldn't be watching the Eagles if we win. A lot of y'all wouldn't be watching the Eagles if we win that Super Bowl in 2017. Y'all not loyal. I ran into dudes on Broad Street talking about, yeah, I just started watching football when they won the Super Bowl. Like, yo, get out of my face. Don't talk to me, bro. Don't talk to me. I'm a diehard Eagles fan, man. Like, diehard. And if y'all ain't rocking with us, like, how y'all supposed to be rocking with us, y'all could leave. Y'all could go be an Indianapolis Colts fan. I love Carson Wentz too, but at the end of the day, I'm an Eagles fan. That's all I care. I bleed that green. And if y'all ain't rocking with us, y'all gonna criticize every little thing, like dude speaking in an interview. Then y'all don't need to be here. It's your boy One Trey Rock. I'm out of here.